Okay, today I'm gonna talk about the skull in the chapter 2. In this chapter, we will deal with the skull as a combined form and individual ones as well. The skull is the bony skeleton of the head in vertebrates, including human beings. It supports the structures of the face and provides a cavity, protective cavity for the brain. So one of the basic functions is to protect the brain from injury. Yes, it houses the brain, the organs of the special sense, such as eye and ear, and the upper parts of the respiratory and digestive systems, including pharynx and larynx, and provides attachment for the many of the muscles of the head and neck. The movement of the skull is restricted and is found only in two locations, in relation to the mandible at the temporomandibular joint and at the atlanto-occipital joint for the movement of the head in relation to the neck. The skull is roughly composed of two parts. I will draw briefly the skull. There is an orbit which houses the eyeball and nasal bone, anterior nasal aperture, brain case, and temporal bone, external acoustic meatus, which is the ear opening, and zygomatic bone. Like this, in the upper teeth, maxillary teeth, and I will draw the mandible like this with mouth opening. Okay. In this figure, we can divide the skull as a cranium and mandible. The upper part is the cranium, and lower part is mandible. Just only one bone. So, except for the mandible, all of the bones of the skulls are joined together by sutures. If I draw the suture line, some of the suture lines, like this one, and the suture around the nasal bone is also a suture, and there are several sutures. Okay, this is a suture. Suture is one of the human joint system, which will be discussed in detail in general skeletal system, can be briefly explained as a immovable joint. For more difficult terms, syn, arthroidal joint, which means the joint formed by the bony ossification, formed by bony ossification. So this joint is nearly immovable. Nearly immovable means that they have very little flexibility, actually, due to the sharpest fiber. The mandible forms the temporomandibular joint, which is the different kinds of joint. In this location, this is another kind of joint, synovial joint. Which is freely movable, actually, and located bilaterally. This is a temporomandibular joint because the comprising jointing, joint comprising bones are the temporal bones and the mandible. Very important joint in the dental field. And based on the embryological origin, the skull consists of three parts: neurocranium and facial skeleton. In addition, there are sutures. Because the suture is not a bone, so we will discuss about two types of individual bones according to the embryological origin. Now, before talking about the detailed anatomy of the skull, we had better know the total number of the bones comprising the skulls and its classifications. This approach helps you memorize the name of the individual bones of skull. The skull totally consists of 14 kinds and 22 pieces of individual bones. Among them, the neurocranium includes 6 kinds and 8 pieces. Facial skeleton has 8 kinds, 14 pieces. Okay, now let's write down the names of the individual bones comprising the neurocranium. First, frontal bone. Parietal bone. Temporal bone. Occipital. Sphenoid. Esmoid. Okay, among them, the parietal bone and temporal bone, the two bones are paired one, which means there are two pieces. The remainder, the others, are unpaired one. So, by this simple equation, we can know the total number of the neurocranium, 8 pieces. The neurocranium can be called, also known as the brain case or brain pan, not pain, and cerebral cranium. Cerebral is the adjective form of the cerebrum. Anyway, in the human skulls, the neurocranium includes the calvaria or skull cap. The remainder of the skull is the facial cranium or facial skeleton. In comparative anatomy, the neurocranium is sometimes used synonymously with endocranium or the chondrocranium. The neurocranium divided into two portions: the membranous part consisting the flat bone which surrounds the brain, such as the frontal, parietal, or occipital, and the cartilaginous part or chondrocranium which forms the bones of the base of skull. The ossicles inside of the ear, 3 on each side, are usually not included as bones of the neurocranium. Below the neurocranium, there are a complex of openings, including the foramen magnum. The neurocranium arises from the paraxial mesoderm. There is also some contribution of ectomesenchyme. Okay, move on to the next session. Now let's write down the names of individual bones comprising the facial cranium. The facial cranium, sometimes called as a facial bone or skeleton, there is a maxilla and mandible, palatine bone, zygomatic bone, nasal bone, lacrimal bone, inferior nasal concha, and finally the vomer. In addition, in our lectures, we will include the hyoid bone into facial cranium. Actually, some textbooks include the hyoid bone into facial cranium. We adopt that notion because, as I said in the first part, this is the lecture of the head and neck anatomy. Okay, the facial skeleton comprises the facial bone that may attach to build a portion of skull. In human anatomy or developmental science, the facial skeleton is sometimes called the membranous viscerocranium, which comprises the mandible and dermatocranial elements that are not part of the brain case. It will be discussed in the embryology part. The facial skeleton is composed of the intramembranous bone, which is sometimes called as a dermal bone or investing bone. They are derived from the neural crest cells or sclerotome, which derives from the somite block of the mesoderm. Variation in the craniofacial form between humans is known to be largely due to the different patterns of the biological inheritance. Okay. Now let's review by this figure. Since some of the individual bones are located inside of this view, they are not seen in this picture. But don't worry, you will meet them very soon. Because this lecture is just introductory, you just encounter name of the individual bones, and you don't need to know the details of them. Okay, we will start from the neurocranium, frontal bone, parietal, temporal, occipital, and sphenoid bone, this bone, and very small portion we can see in this figure, this one is a sesamoid. So all six neurocraniums can be seen in this figure. Now let's move on to the facial cranium, maxilla, mandible, and zygomatic bone, this one, and nasal bone. The lacrimal bone. Among 9 or 8, only the 5 bones can be seen in these sagittal pictures. Okay, now let's summarize this session.
The individual bones comprising the skull can be classified into cerebral cranium and facial cranium. Cerebral cranium can also be called as neurocranium or brain case or brain pan. Facial bone or facial cranium can be called facial skeleton too. There are 6 kinds and 8 pieces of individual bones comprising the neurocranium. They are frontal bone, parietal bone, temporal bone, occipital bone, sphenoid bone, and ethmoid bone. 9 kinds and 15 pieces of individual bones comprise the facial cranium. They are maxilla, mandible, palatine bone, zygomatic bone, nasal bone, lacrimal bone, inferior nasal concha, vomer, and hyoid bone. Among them, these 8 kinds of bones are paired ones. Parietal bone, temporal bone, maxilla, palatine bone, and zygomatic bone, nasal bone, lacrimal bone, inferior nasal conchas are the paired ones, and the remainder 7 kinds of individual bones are the single unpaired ones. So we can calculate the total number of individual bones comprising the skull. In result, total 15 kinds and 23 pieces of bones comprise the skull, and among them 8 kinds of bones are paired one, and the 7 kinds of bones are the unpaired ones. Okay, thank you for your attention.